Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Circular Chart Control. Use pie and doughnut charts to display the proportionality of multiple items against the overall total of a group. In this video, I will show you how to add Syncfusion's MAUI Circular Chart to a MAUI project and enable its basic features such as data labels, legends, and tooltips. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed on your machine. You should also have Visual Studio 2022 installed with the required .NET MAUI workloads. With that confirmed, let's start building an app. I open Visual Studio and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose MAUI app and name my project MAUI example. After that, I continue with the .NET 7 framework and click Create to complete the project creation. Alright, my default application has been created, so let's check the MAUI application's default output by running it. Before that, I will choose an Android emulator from this list and select a Pixel 5 emulator to see the output in that emulator. The application starts to compile the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. Look here, my application says "Hello world, welcome to MAUI app." Now, I will show you the steps to display Syncfusion MAUI Circular Chart Control. First, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Charts NuGet package. So, I stop the debugging and open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Charts package and install it in my project. Click OK to continue the installation. It takes a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. Okay, now let's initialize the MAUI Circular Chart. Before that, I need to register the Syncfusion.NET MAUI trial license key. I open this app XAML CS file and register the trial license key using the register license method. To generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, let's proceed to initialize the control. First, I open this main page.xaml file and remove the default content from the content page section. Inside this page, I import the Syncfusion MAUI charts control namespace. And to the local XML namespace, map the default project namespace. And I include the MAUI circular chart control. Next, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion core handler by making a call to the method configure Syncfusion core. Okay, next I am going to populate the data for the chart. And let me implement this with the MVVM pattern. First, create a folder called model and add a class named data model. Here, I make this class public and define the fields name and sales with appropriate data types. Next, let me assign values for these fields. To do that, first I create a folder called view model and add a class named dataViewModel. Then, make this class public and define a bindable property called ProductsOfTypeDataModel class. And add a constructor for the class. Inside this constructor, to the products property, I add the data objects with the fields, name, and sales. Once it is done, let me navigate to the main page.xaml file to bind the data to the circular chart. Here, I need to set series type for chart, so let me define pie series chart, as I am going to render pie chart. Then, I will add the binding context to the circular chart and access the data view model class here using this local XML namespace. Lastly, I assign the products property to the item's source property and map the data source fields, name to the X binding path property and sales to the Y binding path property. Okay, everything is configured. So, let me save the changes and run this application. Look here, the pie chart displayed with defined data points. Next, I am going to set the title for the chart. So, add the circular chart title property and define the label tag with the text property and set its value to product sales. Then, I customize the title by defining the properties text color to red, horizontal text alignment to center, and font size property to large. As you can see, the pie chart displays the title, product sales, with the customization. Now, let's proceed to see how to add data labels to display information about the data points. To do that, I will define the show data labels property and set its value to true. You can see the pie chart displaying data labels on each of its data points. All right, now I am going to add a legend for the chart. A legend gives more information about the series in the chart. First, I define the legend property and add the chart legend inside this chart code. See the pie chart displaying the legend at the top and giving information about the series in the chart. Next, let's proceed to make the chart more interactive by adding tooltips to it. To do that, I simply define enable tooltip property and set its value to true. Check now, the tooltip is shown for every data point of the pie chart. By default, the pie chart radius will be 0.8. Now, I am going to render a pie chart with a custom radius, so let me define the radius property and set its value to 0.9. Look here, the pie chart rendered with a custom radius. Next, let's proceed to see how to render a semi pie chart. To do that, I simply need to set start angle and end angle properties with custom angles, 180 and 360 respectively. Check now, the semi pie chart rendered. Next, I am going to show you how to highlight a specific segment in the pie chart by exploding them. So, I define explode on touch property and set its value to true. Check now, a specific area in the pie chart can be highlighted by exploding that segment. So far, I have shown you how to render a pie chart and enable some basic features. Now, let's see how to render a doughnut chart. To do that, I simply need to change the chart series type from the pie series to the doughnut series chart. You can see the semi-doughnut chart rendered with defined data points. Suppose I want to render a full doughnut chart, then I remove the start angle and end angle properties from the chart code. Look here, the doughnut chart is displayed. By default, the doughnut chart inner radius will be 0.4. Now, I am going to render a doughnut chart with 0.7 inner radius, so let me add the inner radius property and set its value to 0.7. See here, the doughnut chart rendered with a custom inner radius. Next, I will show you how to highlight a particular segment in a chart series. To do that, I need to enable the selection feature and customize them using the properties selection brush, type, selected indexes, and clear selection. First, I define the selection behavior property and add the data point selection behavior property. Then, I set a custom color code to the selection brush property to highlight a segment in a different color. When I select a particular segment in the chart series, it is highlighted in navy blue color. By default, you can select or highlight only one segment in the chart. If I want to select multiple segments, I simply set the type property to multiple. Apart from the multiple type option, the selection feature also supports three more types such as single, single deselect, and none. Check now, you can select multiple segments at once, and it is highlighted in a different color. In this video, we have seen how to create a .NET MAUI app using Visual Studio 2022 and add a Syncfusion .NET MAUI circular chart control to it. We have learned how to render the pie and donut charts with basic features like legends, data labels, and tooltips. If you would like to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.